After Maidan, I was learning to live anew for several months.
Together with hundreds of like-minded people, Maria Berlinska, a student of Kyiv Mohyla Academy at the time, was one of the first to join the protest.
We were all feeling deceived, and that was what the protest was about.
The first and most important question of this session is the adoption of a set of laws which are necessary for further progress in our European integration. With these words, then-President Viktor Yanukovych opened the parliamentary session. He said he wanted not only for Ukraine to move towards Europe, but for Europe to be built within Ukraine. Yanukovych received a standing ovation. Just a month and a half later, Yanukovych changed his position radically.
Ми сьогодні, условно говоря, не совсем здорові. Сьогодні болеет економіка України. Підписання цього соглашення, що воно нам дає? Я вам скажу, поки що нічого, кроме петлі, ми там не видим.
We are not completely healthy today, so to speak. Ukraine's economy is ill. What does signing this agreement give us? I will tell you. As for now, we don't see anything but a loop. This was how Yanukovych justified his refusal to sign the EU association agreement. Experts are convinced that there were no economic motives. The only reason for the sudden change of plans was pressure from the Kremlin. The Russian Federation switched from mild discussion on the disadvantages of the association agreement to blackmail. Yanukovych needed a lot of money to increase social payments and to win the presidential elections in 2015. He went to Moscow and signed a loan agreement worth $15 billion. It was a bribe for a political decision. On the evening of November 21st, around 1,000 people went to Independence Square in Kyiv, called Maidan Nezalezhnosti in Ukrainian. Among them stood public activists, journalists, and students. Their only demand was the signing of the association agreement with the EU.
It was a very light protest. Every day we would go there, meet our friends, bask in the warmth of fires, sing, make sandwiches, bring water and firewood. It was kind of a childlike, sincere protest without violence. And it would have stayed that way if they hadn't started beating and killing us.
The word Euromaidan was mentioned for the first time on November 21st on Twitter. Over the day, the hashtag was used more than 20,000 times. Ukrainians understood that the course of the country had shifted from the European Union toward the Russian-led Eurasian Customs Union. The majority of lawmakers from the then-president's Party of Regions had been fighting to join it for quite some time. They said that the customs union promised greater economic prospects than the EU. There were no reasons to say that the custom union was in any way beneficial for its members. It is a geopolitical project which is dictated by Russia's desire to outline its sphere of influence symbolically, organizationally, and on the level of regulation. On the night of November 30th, 2013, the authorities decided to crack down on the peaceful protest. At 4 a.m., members of the Berkut Special Police Force started to clear Maidan. Allegedly, force was used only in order to set up a New Year tree. Over 30 activists were injured and 35 more were arrested.
They came and beat us up with metal rods. They were hitting our faces and laughing. They cleared the square in minutes. It was unjustifiably cruel because there was no resistance.
This moment became the tipping point of the revolution. The protesters were now demanding not only the signing of the EU association agreement, but also called for a change of government. Ukraine would then face 4 months of hard struggle with Yanukovych's regime and over 100 deaths on Maidan.
I understood very well that the system we were fighting was controlling us with fear. Maidan won because they got scared of the fact that unarmed people were moving forward.
Maria Berlinska made this speech at the Kyiv Mohyla Academy after Euromaidan. Later, she went to fight in Donbass as an aerial reconnaissance officer. She also founded a center for teaching this profession to others and started collecting aids for soldiers on the front line. Maria says she does all this in order to not let down those who lost their lives during the winter anti-government protests.
We were left alive for some reason. This means we must do something. The people who stood with us are gone now. Their deaths shouldn't be in vain.